Step 3, interference with single photons. I'm sure you have already seen the scenario of a double-slit experiment with laser light, but let's review it again. In this experiment, we've got a source of coherent light, so a laser. And it's turned on, and the laser light is incident on a screen where there are only two small double slits where the light can go through. And then it propagates towards another screen where we detect a pattern. And the pattern that we see looks something like this. We've got fringes of bright light and then these white fringes where there is no light. Why is that? As you can see, as the light is propagating through here, these lines, they represent the peaks of the electromagnetic wave, whereas the space in between them represent the valleys, the troughs. So as the two waves go through these slits, they have a chance to interfere constructively or destructively. Where their peaks meet, the wave, the interference of the two waves reinforces their amplitude. On the other hand, if a peak meets a trough or a valley, then the amplitudes cancel. And here we can see these light blue lines. These are the lines along which we see constructive interference. For example, here we see the light coming from the top slit, light coming from the bottom slit, and they go towards the screen. The path length of these two paths are equal. Therefore, there is no phase difference between the two waves coming from the top slit and the bottom slit, and we observe constructive interference. On the other hand, for this other fringe, the path length for this top path is a little bit shorter than the bottom one. But the phase difference introduced for this case is exactly 2 pi, which again corresponds to a constructive interference as we have seen in the previous step. And similarly for the other fringes. For this top one, we have a phase difference of 4 pi. On the other hand, if we consider this other path, as we said, this is where peaks meet the troughs. So this is where the path differences are odd integer multiple of pi. So for this first dark region on the screen, we've got the path, the phase difference being pi. For the second dark region on the screen, we've got the phase difference being 3 pi. Now, let's consider the scenario where we attenuate the laser light to such low levels that it's only firing single photons at a time. And furthermore, the level of attenuation is so high that we can be pretty sure that there's only one photon at a time between this screen where we place the double slits and the screen where we are recording the pattern. So what happens? Well, we know that the photons must go through one of these slits. So let's try and cover one of them. What do we expect? If we cover the bottom one, then definitely the photons have to go through the top slit in order to hit the screen. So we expect most of the photons hitting the screen in this region that's the closest to the top slit. On the other hand, if we block the top slit and the photons are allowed to pass through this bottom slit, then we expect most of the photons to be recorded on the screen over here. What happens if we open both of the slits? Well, they can go through the top, and they can go through the bottom, so we expect something like this. We expect that the two previous distributions are just added together. Is this really what we see? Well, let's find out. In fact, what we see is the following. We start firing photons at the screen. Originally, there's not much pattern that we can discern, but as the time progresses, as more and more photons hit the screen, we can clearly see these fringes being formed. These fringes are the same fringes as we could see before with strong laser light, as shown here. So let's just pause and appreciate really what's going on. We saw these fringes on the right with a strong laser light, and it wasn't very surprising. However, here, somehow each individual photon knows that they still need to follow the same pattern. Still, they are drawn towards these bright fringes on the screen, and they avoid these dark fringes in between them. This is because of interference of different possible paths. Even though we always have a single photon in our interferometer, still it obeys the same rules of interference as if we had a strong laser pulse.